If your music comes from your heart and soul, and if you feel it inside yourself, it will affect others in the same way.
My relationship with music is fairly intense, I would say. I listen to a variety of different genres. I write it as well, and I play it. Sometimes I get into a state of mind where it's just like I'm in my zone. I would like to think that nothing could distract me. It can be a nice feeling, but it can also be quite a daunting feeling.
Hello, are you Tom?
Yes.
Hi, pleased to meet you. I've just had a look at the score. It looks quite theatrical.
It is.
Yeah.
Stravinsky's work, The Rite of Spring, influenced me a lot. It has a lot of very unusual features in it. Like, it opens with a very high-pitched, strangled bassoon melody, and I use that same melody, actually, in the Sixth Sense piece.
Can we stop there, actually? Can I just focus on that little moment we just heard? So that's just it's from the second bar of B.
With this piece, I was experimenting a lot with it. Like, I wasn't sure where it was going to go or what it was going to do, but I just wanted to make it different from the rest of my stuff.
It's interesting speaking to composers whether they set out to create a mood before they start writing, or the mood just creates itself in the writing of the music.
I think more the latter, really.
Yeah.
There's something in the work of a composer, like other artists, that reflects something of our shared humanity back at the listeners. So the composer is trying to encapsulate something of what it means to be human.
The most rewarding thing about writing music is once you hear it performed. That hasn't happened too often to me, but when it has, it's a really nice feeling. It just gives you something that a recording would never give you. There's like this sense of adrenaline that rushes through you. Once you hear a piece reaching its conclusion, it's just, it's indescribable, really.